Right. we here, we serve the great I am. Whoa. Everyone have their Bibles. We turn to Proverbs chapter 12. Book of Proverbs chapter 12. Whoever loves instruction loves knowledge, but he who hates correction is stupid. A good man obtains favor from the Lord, but a man of wicked intentions he will condemn. A man is not established by wickedness, but the root of the righteousness cannot be moved. An excellent wife is the crown of her husband, but she who causes shame is like rottenness to his bone. The thoughts of the righteous are right, but the counsels of the wicked are deceitful. The words of the wicked are lie and wait of blood, but the mouth of the upright will deliver them. The wicked are overthrown and are no more, but the house of the righteous will stand. A man will be commended according to his wisdom, but he who is a perverse heart will be despised. Better is the one who is slighted but has a servant than he who honors himself but lacks bread. A righteous man regards the life of his animal, but the tender mercies of the wicked are cruel. I've read to you Proverbs chapter 12, verses 1 through 10. May God give a blessing to the readers and hearers and doers of His holy word.
Amen.
We have the church bulletin. We'll read the church tab. Having been led as we believe by the Spirit of God to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior.
And on the profession of our faith, having been baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
We do now, in the presence of God, angels, and this assembly, most solemnly and joyfully, enter into covenant with one another as one body in Christ.
We engage, therefore, by the aid of the Holy Spirit, to walk together in Christian love, to strive for the advancement of His church in knowledge, holiness, and comfort.
To promote His prosperity and His spirituality, to sustain His worship, ordinance, discipline, and doctrines.
To contribute cheerfully and regularly to the support of the ministry, the expenses of the church, the relief of the poor, and the spread of the gospel through all nations.
We also engage to maintain family and secret devotions, to religiously educate our children, to seek the salvation of our kindred and acquaintances.
To walk circumspectly in the world, to be just in our dealings, faithful in our engagements, and exemplary in our deportment.
To avoid all tattling, backbiting, and excessive anger.
To abstain from the sale and the use of intoxicating drinks at the present, and to be zealous in our efforts to advance the kingdom of our Savior.
We further engage to watch over one another in brotherly love.
To remember each other in prayer, to aid each other in sickness and distress, to cultivate Christian sympathy in feeling and courtesy in speech.
To be slow to take offense, but always ready for reconciliation, and mindful of the rules of our Savior to secure it without delay.
We moreover engage that when we remove from this place, church, where we can carry out the spirit of this covenant and the principles of God's word. Amen.
Church in this country, Lord. my pastor, and this first lady, Lord. Lord, we ask you to touch them. Anoint them, Lord. Give them what they need, Father, to be the leaders that they continue to be, Lord. Just, Lord, continue to bless them. Lord, continue to keep them. Lord, continue to bless them. Continue to anoint them, Lord.
Thank you. Welcome.
Why, thank you.
Yes, I know. We welcome our church as well as our internet audience.
Yes.
These are announcements for this Sunday, January the 7th. Martin Luther King Jr. holiday is Monday, January the 15th. Amen. Valentine's Day is on Wednesday, February the 14th. Amen?
Amen.
Well, Good Friday is March the 30th, and Resurrection Sunday is April the 1st. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, my God, we just go on with this. Our 40 days of fasting and prayer will begin towards Resurrection Sunday on Wednesday, February the 14th through Saturday, March the 31st. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. A copy of our fast and prayer guide to assist one through our 40 days will be available on next week. Amen?
Amen.
God is pleased when we acknowledge Him first.
First.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If you are on social media, post our events on your page and invite others. Amen?
Amen.
Please keep a copy of our announcements for your weekly scheduling. Amen?
Amen.
We stream live at 10:30 a.m. on Facebook every Sunday. Mm-hmm. If you're watching our church service on Facebook or YouTube, let God lead you to make an offering, which supports our social media ministry. Amen?
Amen.
Simply download the Givelify app to make an electronic offering. Amen?
Amen.
Our regular weekly service event times are as follows. Every first Sunday is our Communion Sunday service at 10:30 a.m., like today.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Wednesday night Bible study at Pastor Smith's house. Every Sunday morning is an exciting Sunday school lesson with energetic teaching from our team of teachers starting at 9:30 a.m. Our wonderful Sunday morning worship service starts online live at 10:30 a.m.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Baptisms and baby dedications are to be announced. Please enjoy the rest of your Sunday with Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We do have refreshments after our benediction. We welcome our guests, hoping something is said to encourage you. We really want to encourage everyone in 2018.
Amen.
Please make sure our guests today receive a welcome packet from one of our ushers. Amen.
Amen.
Our ushers do have offering envelopes in their hands, and they do a wonderful job every Sunday, and we thank each and every one of you. If you would like an envelope, now please raise your hand and our ushers will provide you with one. After today's service, our ushers will direct you to our fellowship hall where we can place your tithes and your offerings. Amen?
Amen.
These are our announcements for this first Sunday, January the 7th, 2018. As our minister prepares to pray over our giving today, please govern yourselves accordingly. Amen and Happy New Year.
Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Let's look to the Lord. God, we thank you for yet another opportunity to give to you. God, we ask, Lord, that you accept what we have with the sweet smell of the savor in your nostrils. God, we ask you to bless those that have desire to give but could not give, Lord, that they may come next time and partake with us. Thank you, pray you in advance, in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Thank you.
many know that the Lord is awesome?
Awesome!
How many love you serve an awesome God? Thank you.
Oh,
thank God for a new year. We thank God for Faith Christian Baptist Church and what God has done in the midst of our existence and the internet. We thank God for each and every one of you, beloveds. We know that God is able. Amen. 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 God is truly able. And I just ask that you specifically on this morning show your love to the Word of God. Amen. Not to your pastor, but to the Word of God. It's important on this day. Amen. And I must encourage you, God is able. We might say that quite a bit, but can I tell you, God is able.
Hallelujah! Yes! Yes!
He's able. Does anyone know that God is able? Amen. 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 Sometimes you never know what you walk into, and I always say, you have to stay prayed up for somebody else. I just need some help right now. That's all I'm asking for, some help. God is using his people. Amen. I just need some help right now. Yes, indeed. Yes, he's able. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our internet audience. We thank you for our beloved people here right now. Lord, we ask that you strengthen us. Use me for thee. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Lord, search my heart. Guide my thoughts. If there be any wicked way in me, lead me now in the way everlasting. Lord, protect me. Cover me. Let me be your vessel for your people right now. Let this word be a confirming word to those who's already asked the question, what must I do to be saved? I thank you for this covering of the blood of Jesus upon me, upon your church, upon your people, upon this building, right now, in Jesus' mighty name. Let the church say, sometimes you just need that lifting up. Amen? Amen. Amen. We thank God for our prayer team. We thank God for our praise ministry. We thank God for everyone here on today. Amen? Can I tell you, and I'm dating this message, this is the first sermon on this 2018, and I thank God for our internet audience, and I just want to encourage you, there is a word from the Lord.
Right.
Amen. 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 It's good to see all of you who crossed over, amen,
amen,
to 2018, amen. Amen, hallelujah. Turn with me to Psalms 103, Psalms 103. Now, I'm just going to encourage you, this is January, so every January is stewardship month, amen? Every January is stewardship month, but the Lord continued to give me a word on right now. It's a right on time word, and it's appropriate for what God is doing right now, amen? Amen, amen. Psalms 103. And I'll be reading from the New King James. Mm-hmm. Psalms 103. Amen. If you have it, say, I have it.
I have it.
Amen. Amen. All right. I'm just going to give you a couple of verses, and then we'll go from there. Amen?
Amen.
The scriptures tell us in verse number 8,
of Psalms 103. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. That's your shout right there.
That's it right there.
Thank you.
Verse 9 says, he will not always shy, neither will he keep his anger forever.
That's it.
He hath not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. Verse 11 says, for as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy towards them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgression from us. Tell your neighbor, I'm free.
I'm free.
I'm free.
If I could, you may be serious. Amen. Amen. He has removed our transgressions from us. I need some help up in here. If I could, just for a moment, talk to you from the title of this text. Wiping the slate clean. Wiping the slate clean. I'm just gonna go ahead and help you out, because maybe you missed your shout through the verses right now. But somebody needs to know your slate has been wiped clean. And somebody needs to know that God is able. And somebody needs to know that you have moved into 2018 and God has wiped the slate clean. And you have to know, in the midst of knowing that we all have sinned and come short of the glory, he tells me in the word of God, he removed our transgression from us. I just need some help right now. Some of y'all might have walked in here. You might have been coming in here looking like Sad Sack. Y'all know the cartoon Sad Sack. And in the midst of that, God is here to encourage you.
Yeah.
I got you.
Amen. All right now. All right now.
Oh, man, somebody didn't hear me. God is here to encourage you. Let me say it this way. I'm here to wipe your slate clean. I'm here to help somebody know, no matter how you thought yesterday was, how you thought last night was, how you thought a minute was, you got to understand, I got your back.
Thank you, Lord.
The text tells us, in the midst of what David is saying, he tells us the Lord is merciful and gracious. And sometimes we need to know, in the midst of our lives and how we look at this season after season after season, we keep asking God, Lord, are you going to take this away from me? Are you going to help me out? Are you going to let me go through another season of torment? Oh, I don't know who I'm preaching to. Maybe it's the internet. Maybe you're going to let me go through another season of heartache and pain, suffering in my surroundings.
Come on now.
Stuck in my situation. I can't flip the soil. I can't go ahead and plow the land. I was talking to the first lady this weekend. I can't go ahead and prepare the time.
All right, come on now, come on.
I can't till the land.
Yeah, come on.
All right. And then we had the conversation the harvest is plenty.
Yes.
All right.
And depending on whatever the translation is, and it's important to understand in how you look at the original text, because the translations might put a conjunction in there. And you have to know the harvest is plenty.
Yeah.
And I would safely say the laborers are few.
All right now. Yeah.
And watch this. Watch this. God has come here today to wipe the slate clean because he's come here to help you out.
Yeah.
Because in the midst of Faith Christian Baptist Church, the laborers. But God didn't say the harvest wasn't plenty.
Come on, boy. Come on now.
Oh, y'all missed your shot there in a minute. Because in the midst of knowing how Faith Christian Baptist Church been handling their business.
Yeah. Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
We still here.
Yes.
Tap your neighbor, I'm still here.
I'm still here.
Because y'all been taking care of your business. You just not a part-time Bible reader. I need some help. You just not a portion Bible reader. You just not trying to read one section of the Word of God. You believe all 66 books of the Word.
Yeah.
God has allowed you to understand. You got to shout because when you sow, you'll see. We talked about this in the car. Ask her. Just ask her. Tap her on the shoulder. I got to talk to you after church.
She's confirmed.
We was headed to the men's convention. I'm giving it props. But I'm wearing the shirt that you see I bought.
You got to look good at what you wear.
Amen.
That's right.
And of course, I had to make sure she had hers. And she wear it. She looks good. I got to take care of mama.
That's it. Stop.
And so all of a sudden we're driving down the road.
Uh-huh.
And then we're talking about the Word of God.
Yeah.
And then we discover she's all in my text. And so I have to keep on driving. I'm going to act like Willie Foo Foo Salmon Sausage. What you say? What you say? And all of a sudden I'm saying dilly dilly. Wiping the slate clean. God is going to tell you, beloveds, you've been in this church for years. And your time, your talent, and your treasure is allowing you to understand the Word of God.
Yeah.
See, that covers all 66 books.
Yeah.
We can't be focused on one section. Well, no. It ain't all about what your money does.
On,
I need some help up
come
in
come
here.
On,
you got to understand your time
uh-huh.
and your talent.
Yeah.
Oh,
come on, man.
Come on, can I preach this? Can I really preach this? You got to understand, the Faith Christian Baptist Church is blessed. No matter how many people I can count up in here, because everybody that come up in here finally figure out.
Come on, Pastor.
You can't beat God's giving.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
No matter how hard you try. That's why he tells us so great uh-huh. is his mercy
yeah.
toward them
yeah.
that fear him. Beloved, oh, watch this. I'll preach this in a minute. You can't be God's giving because you got to know he loves you.
Come on.
Amen.
The Bible says so.
You can't love me like God.
Come on.
I'm just a vessel.
Yeah.
You got to love God enough to give your time, to give your talent, and to give your treasure.
Yeah.
So let me help you, because you can't get grudgingly.
Come on now. All right now.
Tell your neighbor he wiping the slate clean. You don't have to like what I'm preaching, but when you give, and so that opens up the door for grace.
Yeah.
He tells us the Lord is merciful and gracious.
Yeah.
So thank God for his grace and mercy, because now his children of God, his children of God, don't miss this, his children of God gives back.
Yeah.
Watch this, what you couldn't pay for.
Ooh. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
All right.
That's for the internet. Because I know this church know what I'm talking about. Because it doesn't matter how many it is, what matters is, and I'm going to break away from Malachi for a minute. I'm going to break away from Malachi 3 and 6. I'm going to break away from what Malachi tells us. Bring ye the tithe to the storehouse. Because if you ain't bringing the tenth in the first place, Abraham couldn't have done what he did to Melchizedek.
Come on.
I know it got quiet up
here.
But let me help you.
Right,
this is a grace giving church.
Yeah.
You give above and beyond the tithe. You give what God is on your heart.
Yeah.
And what's good.
Yeah.
And gracious and merciful. That's why we're still here.
Yes.
It's nothing more precious than understanding that God is wiping the slate clean. Because he's allowing us to understand, I can't beat God's giving. Who is getting high up in here? I can't understand how good and how gracious he is. I can't understand it. But it's not for me to understand. It's for me to just know that God is in my life. And so all of a sudden, I see what God is doing. He's allowing me to understand in the midst of the winter.
Come on now.
Oh, y'all, can I go here for a minute?
Come on, work it.
You know how it is. In the wintertime, everybody stay cooped up in the house. Everybody stay locked up in the house. In other words, all that clutter starts accumulating. All the drapes need wiping down. All the curtains need wiping down. And we have to understand, everything ain't always smelling the way it
should.
Y'all pray for me. I said I'm going to preach this. But isn't it a joy when God comes and wipes the slate clean? Isn't it a joy to understand that God comes and cleans your house? Isn't it a joy to know in the midst of your mindset and how you was looking at life, God said, you know what? If you put your trust in me, if you put your belief in me and have the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, I'm going to heal your cancer. I'm going to heal your sickness. I'm going to heal whatever you're going through. Whether it's family issues, whether it's job issues, whatever it is, I'm going to take care of it.
Yes.
Watch this. Sometimes we got to go through a winter situation.
Come on, talk to us.
Sometimes we got to understand, I know we're saintly, I know we're children of God, I know in the midst of our behavior, we got to go ahead and watch out for God's unchanging hand.
Yeah.
But every time I turn around, the devil's always,
always,
Pastor, I need some help. need some hope.
Yeah.
I need some loving.
Yeah.
And God is saying, look, just continue to trust in me. Because I came here to tell somebody I'm wiping the slate clean. Oh, watch this. You've been through some troublesome feuds. I don't know who I'm talking about, but you've been through some trouble. You've been through some bad situations. You've been through some places you couldn't even clean up on your own.
Hallelujah.
Slap fire with your neighbor. God is wiping my slate clean. And sometimes we try to put a lid on it.
Come on, Pat. Come on.
Tell your neighbor. See, you heard Beyonce say put a ring on it?
Yeah.
Put a prayer on it.
Well, Christians say put a lid on it. They try to put a lid on what God can handle. In other words, let me break that down. You try to take care of what God is already doing in your life. So now you undergo some part-time cleanup. It's a mess out there, ain't it? And so now we see this is King David's problem. This is David's problem. This is his situation. But he was a man after God's own heart.
Yeah, that's right, man.
And that's why when me and the first lady going back to the illustration, while we was driving down the road, we were headed down the road.
Yeah.
And we got to understand, you can't have a harvest without laborers. So depending on what translation you look at, if you see the harvest is plenty, but that means something's canceled out, I would suggest to go to the original translation and understand. I believe God is really saying something more. To say the harvest is plenty and the laborers are few. I'm just saying it in my paraphrasing voice.
Yeah.
And I want to encourage somebody today, because when you look at this, you got to understand, here we are.
Yeah.
And God has wiped the slate clean, but yet and still, the church, to me, is full.
Yeah, amen, amen.
Why? Because you're full of what God has to give.
Yeah.
Because you're already giving back what you couldn't pay for. That's why David is saying, have mercy upon me.
Yeah.
That's why he was singing the song, have mercy on me. Oh God, he was telling us, according to thy loving kindness, have mercy on me. And isn't it something that we all pray for every day?
Amen.
When we wake up in the morning, we pray. When we go to sleep at night, we pray. When we're dealing with situations, we pray. In other words, we're just having a little talk with Jesus.
Yeah.
And isn't it something, when you have a talk with God, you can see how David saw. You can understand, yes, I am just like David. I'm dealing with a God that's after my own heart. Oh, you know David. David went through some different situations in his life.
Yeah.
And so God is saying, look, just like anything in our own life, we can't hold on to our past.
Come on now.
Nope. Amen. Nope.
Come on, sir.
Okay, let me go a little further. I didn't get everybody. David had to deal with the awful fact that his past just ate away in him.
Yeah.
And isn't it tough when somebody just wants to keep throwing your past at you?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Ooh, can I preach this for a minute?
Yeah. Yeah.
Even if they're in your own house.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Even if they at your job.
Yeah.
even if they your friends or your enemies. They don't even know you and they're your enemy. They throwing your past all up there because I heard about you. But can I tell you, when you keep on singing the Lord's Prayer, when you keep on praying, when you keep on letting God know that the Lord is my shepherd, that I shall not want. He lets me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Those are the things you keep your mind on. Yes, you turn the other cheek. Yes, you shake the dust. But sometimes you got to stay prayed up. David acknowledged his transgressions. And that's what we have to understand. Acknowledge what you've been through. And sometimes people just do it on purpose. They want to throw stuff up at you. And all you can do is depend on God.
That's it.
In your name, I'm wiping the slate clean.
See, and
that's what's important, beloveds. Because you can't do unto others as they. I need some help up in here. And you got to understand, we're shaping in iniquity. God allows us to understand. He molded us. He allowed us to understand that we have a heart for him. So now he shows us in Psalms 51 verses 1 through 13, David's song. And that's a song for everyone who deals with people who try to bring up your history. And you got to understand, it don't matter who it is, because you be surprised. Can I say that? How close the devil get to you. And the enemy ain't gonna come through no furniture. Okay, you didn't get that? He gonna come to someone who has a mouth.
Right.
Can't say I'll say amen.
Amen.
That's why we got to individually stay prayed up.
Yes.
Because we don't know where it's gonna come from.
Hallelujah.
You be running around here like Jesse Jackson running for president. Dodging everything, but you put on the shield. You put on the armor of God. You keep on walking. Shod with the preparation of the gospel of truth. You keep the word in your heart.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
That's why it's important as we prepare this year. Because some of y'all might have forgotten because you got blessed so good. What it took to get you to that blessing.
Yeah.
And that's why I talk about in the midst of every year we pray and fast.
Yeah.
We got to prepare for the blessing. Amen. We got to get in position for the blessing. Amen. We got to be prayed up and understand what God has for you.
Yes, sir.
It's for you.
So
David decided many things, but he wanted to get rid of the pain. Mm-hmm. He wanted to get rid of the past. He wanted the good news. And guess what? Just like David, God has heard each and every one of you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
He hears you right now.
Amen.
Just continue to talk. With Jesus.
Yeah.
Just continue to have a talk
yes.
with Jesus.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because the good news is that he's a forgiving God. The good news is that he's a merciful God. The good news is that he's a gracious God. If we confess our sins to one another, and that's what James tells us. And we have to be mindful that we got to stay prayed up because we pray for one another.
Yeah.
We pray for one another. We continue to know the heart of God. Why? Because we know what God has brought us through.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
We know what compassion and forgiveness does. We know in the midst of protecting ourselves, in the midst of blindness, in the midst of what the enemy might do, we got to be knowing that we put our hand on God. God is certainly who he says he is.
Yeah.
That's why he shows us we do need mercy.
Yes, we do.
We need mercy so much that he shows us to this point that we need mercy because we can't forgive ourselves.
Come on now.
Can I just park there for a minute?
Park.
Y'all might not like this mess.
Come on now.
Wiping the slate clean.
Yes.
See, we need mercy because there's no way you can forgive yourself. How you going to forgive yourself when somebody up there talking about you? And you know it's your closest family member. Ooh, your closest friend. Your closest one that you trusted at the job. How you going to forgive yourself? That's why God shows us in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7, that Paul tells us there's a thorn in my flesh.
Yeah.
We don't know what that thorn is.
Right.
But he shows us that it's always going to be there. Uh-huh. So in other words, we're crying out to God, watch this. God, this is Paul, come get this. Didn't David have something dealing with just like Paul? But the word says, created me a
clean heart
that I may renew a
right spirit
within me.
Yes.
You can't renew yourself. You can't forgive yourself. You got to have a talk. Wiping the slate clean.
Right,
am I preaching today? Am I talking to anybody today? We need mercy. You can't do it on your own. We can't forgive ourselves, but God can. He does it because he loves us. He does it because he doesn't want us to be sinful. He does it because he doesn't want us to be wicked. He does it because he doesn't want us to be corrupt. God desires us, beloveds. He desires our heart. He desires us. And guess who else desires us? But God loves us. So we love him. Because he first loved us. So we can't fall into the snare, the trap of what the devil would do.
Come on, man.
So God cleans us. He cleans us up. He cleans us up. And so we can stand in his presence.
Yes, sir.
And through that, there's forgiveness. There's forgiveness. Why? Because of the death and the burial of Jesus Christ. So in other words, Jesus paid it all.
Yes, sir.
Paid all for my mess. I'm talking about me. I ain't talking about anyone else. He's wiped my slate clean. I'm talking about me. Because he's wiped my slate clean. I'm talking about me. Because he took all the mess of sin.
Right.
That's sin nature.
Yeah.
We know in Genesis, all right? Uh-huh. We all know what we've gone through.
Uh-huh.
In other words, he created in me a clean heart that I may worship. Come on, y'all.
Yeah.
That I may worship him. So in other words, he took care of my past. He took care of my present.
Yeah.
And he took care of my future. I'm trying to help somebody because he's wiped my slate clean.
Yeah.
And so God also shows us in the midst of knowing that we can't forgive ourselves, we also need mercy because mercy suits our case. And when we think about that, can I just talk about it for a minute? Because God is the best doctor you ever met. He's the best lawyer you ever going to. And he's the best heart fixer because he's a mind regulator. So God, in the midst of our wise counsel, in the midst of who he's doing this for, he shows us in the midst of our past, present, and future, he shows us God doesn't deal with us according to our sins. Don't miss that right there. God does not deal with us according to our sins because he couldn't. He can't. I'm just saying, God is omnipotent, God is all-knowing, and God is all-seeing. But can I help you? God can't deal with us according to our sins because otherwise we'd be dead right now. Ain't that right, Minister Lewis? You know the word of God. But God says sin invokes justice. Somebody help me right now. I'll say it again. Sin invokes justice. But he pardons our mercy. He has mercy on us. So in other words, we have a pardon. We have a pardon. In other words, mercy tells me, I don't care what you've done. It's all in your past.
Yes.
The slate is wiped clean. The slate is clean. All of your sin is erased. Even the ones you committed just 5 minutes ago. You got to understand, if it's 5 days, 5 minutes, or 5 seconds, he says in his word in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9, he says, my grace, my grace, my grace is sufficient for thee. And somebody needs to know, God has come and wiped my slate clean. Somebody needs to know that my grace, he's already given us sufficiency. He's already allowed us to understand his grace and his mercy. I'm excited now. I feel like shouting because his grace is sufficient for me. No matter what I've gone through 5 minutes ago, no matter what kind of anger I might have gone through, what kind of heartache I might have gone through, thank God his grace and his mercy blots out my transgressions. His grace and his mercy takes hellfire out of my mind. His grace and his mercy shows me heaven. His grace and his mercy allows me to understand what David did. Some of you understand, David danced. David shouted. David had joy because his mercy was sufficient. His grace was sufficient. I don't know about you, but I get excited to know that God has wiped the slate clean. I get excited because God has put a covenant of grace and mercy. But not only did he do that, it was Jesus at the cross. It was Jesus at Calvary. It was Jesus that showed me the only covenant. The only covenant that's more important than anything I could have thought of. It was the blood of Jesus. The blood. The blood. The blood has cleansed me. The blood of Jesus. Jesus, 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 for the love of Jesus, had it not been for the love of Jesus on my side, where would I be? Where would I be?
Give God your heart. Give the pastor your hand. God bless you. The doors of the church are open right now.